Ko anw fɛ farafinna yan mɔgɔkɔrɔba kelen o kelen mana sa a bɛ ko dɔɔninso kelen jeni
If you wish to know who I am, if you wish me to teach you what I know, cease for a while to be what you are and forget what you know. The caravans of old followed the rivers and timeless trails across the continent of Africa. Not only did people barter salt and gold, they also exchanged knowledge, experiences, and stories. Timbuktu and Djenne, on the southern fringe of the desert, became meeting places for sages and learned people. Until about 4,000 years ago, the Sahara was fertile savanna. And it was here that some of the first of the world's major civilizations evolved. Along the Niger and the Nile, traces still exist of the advanced cultures of antiquity. Ancient Egypt, Nubia, the kingdom of Aksum in Ethiopia, and the powerful Malian kingdoms in the west. In Lalibela stand ancient stone churches hewn from solid rock, relics of the world's first Christian nation, Ethiopia. The Ethiopian Orthodox Church holds that here in Aksum is the holiest relic of Old Testament faith, the stone tablets Moses received from God on Mount Sinai. This was the origin of a caravan of sagas, myths, and legends that have set their seal on the religious history of the world for close on 3,000 years. But Africa also witnessed the growth of cultures with no written alphabet. And this provided the impetus for oral transmission of stories and learning from the distant past. The Caravan of Knowledge has wound its way through the landscape and history of Africa. And nowadays, the oral traditions it fostered are kept alive by medicine men, nomads, small farmers, fishermen, and tribal elders.
Aïe. Le fait même qu'on craint que l'Afrique soit en rupture avec sa capacité de création qui l'a caractérisée depuis les temps anciens, depuis le temps des pharaons en Égypte, depuis le temps de l'empire de Meroé au Soudan, Nubique. Cette crainte même est comme l'artiste et la vedette devant son public qui a le tract. C'est justement pour éviter à cette rupture, pour échapper à cette rupture, que l'interrogation rappelle que l'Afrique a besoin de sa culture, de sa capacité de créativité, si elle ne veut pas perdre.
About 10,000 women around the lake shores of Lake Victoria, they have lost their business because all the fish are being taken to their fish factories. So they can only depend only on the carcass.
On my hand is a skeleton. It's known as a dogfish in my country. They export the whole fillet into European countries, and this is what we remain with. And therefore, we don't earn a lot from this, and this is what we live on. It's totally naked. So after frying, you find that it's all bones. It's not fair.
We depend on this lake. What are we going to be left with? Because they are going to empty the lake and will remain here and they will go away. So they have only come for their fortune and will remain poorer than as we are now. So it is very, very, very threatening. My boat is not very big one, it is a moderate one, and I'm using it to fish tilapia and the Nile perch. We, especially like myself, are born here, my children are born here, my father was born here, and my grandfather also was born here. It is now about 24 years since I started fishing. Before we had a system, we had our own traditional method of preserving the lake. We had certain periods when fishing was banned, the seasons when people were allowed to go out fishing, and the number of gears were also regulated. So now it has changed. More security as before. So we would like our traditional methods brought back to preserve the fish so that our coming generations can have access to the different species that we have here now.
if foreign interference was a source of development, then Africa should be the most developed continent in the whole world. Because we have had the most foreign interference. That's what I always tell them. I said, if foreign interference was a source of development, then we should be in the space age now. I don't blame outsiders. I think the outsiders take advantage of our weaknesses.
Nous sommes dans un monde aujourd'hui où il est difficile de se singulariser, d'être autonome, d'affirmer son identité. C'est très difficile parce que nous sommes dans un monde globalisé.
Of the caravan of knowledge go deep, but they also take us forward into the Africa of tomorrow. In Dogonland in Mali, aged wise men and modern doctors have begun to pool their knowledge and skills. The medicine man has his own way of preparing himself. With the aid of dances and ancient rituals, he seeks contact with his forebears in a quest for the power required to heal the sick.
Ago ila bona yo ada yo. Doko na mungundo ago amba mana gya e ona gya mo.
D'accord. Bon, Paris, Paris, nous.
abe dimi gamma nyongo doge fin kuliki wa kuliki nyongo nuno aka kamelege ali aba ka susuga ni nyongo mogo musoto nani do kiedo do bombu gonjo ni gonjo ya ni ni kilente ko
Je pense que nous avons appris beaucoup de choses avec les thérapeutes traditionnels. D'abord, leur compréhension de l'homme dans sa globalité, pas seulement de façon symptomatique, mais aussi spirituelle.
Est-ce que Fato froid
Ah, le Moron a brûlé ton yang yang lindo. Mais à ma mère, on connaît à bas aussi.
C'est ça. Toc l'endo indo.
Il connaît à bé yangan ou Moron a t'y yanganaka. Nakashi.
Ok, d'accord. Est-ce que tension comme il a fallu? Afra ko tension ko mi la folo
mame
imame
mata afle loto
mata afle doto don ina na andro
condition mi ne kan yam ni sisa kan ko ko be mi na ka digi ni na
sada ga ya ba de ba su ko ka de amba mana ga ya amba mana ga langa mala ba su ko ka de ha go ba su
nim bana ba to bora mo optika na ko ay ya afra ke
do be ambi to bi ka ka konai ka mo ka kigi bo we are for mutiny we are from banani ale aduna ajula a banani we chukano ma mai pe kata ko de kama nana nai
abi laban fikri mina fikri olu kono fikri dongo donde
dongo do we am pisilin no kanana na sebele meo okay
tanga tata kanaya di
ha Aye, I can't. You never allow. I said, I'm best man in bed.
I'm going to Nangawa. I'm going to Abamana. I'm going to Nangawa.
La médecine africaine n'a jamais considéré l'homme comme une pièce de véhicule que l'on dissèque, on analyse, on sépare, on prend l'homme, on l'extrait de sa famille, de son village pour l'hôpital, on le traite. Si on le remet dans la famille, on n'a pas réglé tout le problème. La médecine africaine est totalisante, elle est totale, elle est entière. Elle met à contribution la vie familiale, la vie du quartier, l'utilité sociale, la conscience des gens. On est en plein dans une approche que le savoir ancien avait bien compris, avait bien posée. La science moderne n'est pas en rupture avec la science et l'approche du savoir ancien. Il s'agit de les mettre en synergie, en convergence, pour que l'on se rende compte que c'est pour le bonheur du grand nombre, le bonheur de tout le monde, y compris les autochtones que les étrangers, y compris qu'ici, que l'au-delà, que ailleurs.
The masquerade is sort of the physical representation of the ancestor world. It's supposed to have the wisdom of the past as well as the wisdom of the living. Tradition and modernization meet, you know, interact all the time. Tradition is not static, culture is not static. And so there's no real contradiction for me between tradition and modernity. Because nothing stands still. Ogun, from being the god of iron, of war and lyric, becomes the god of the motor mechanic, of the, you know, the, I'm sure of the astronaut also, the moment we have one. You'll find even the most sophisticated railway engineer going to his village to celebrate the festival of Ogun, because Ogun is the god of metal. That way, knowledge is constantly being absorbed and reworked through and interiorized systematization of the world. So the gods have set the example. What excuse are the mortals for not following the same route?
Ah, yeah, yeah. When I started fire work in the field, I realized that pastoralists have a deep knowledge of livestock keeping. It was very important for me to start understanding on how they keep livestock and how they manage their animals' problems before I started providing my input on modern approaches. So I had to go out and start learning from them. What do they do?
Inatoa minyoo gani, aina gani ya minyoo?
Natoa nini, yote.
Yote.
Natoa yote. Yeye kama na wanajua sisi nafanya namna hii, anashukua masisi.
Masisi, yeah.
Masisi yake.
In this district, I'm working with three healers. Two men who are Samburu and one Turkana lady. The traditional knowledge has also developed in a long process of trial and error. Actually, this process that the healers have used is very comparable to the science. It's actually a science by itself. Well, what they are doing here is that they are actually fixing a fracture, a broken limb. And from what we have learned is that the healing is, it seems to be faster than what we do. Here we see that the traditional knowledge or traditional practices is far better than the modern science. They seem to heal faster. They have a specific plant that they give when an animal has a fracture. So when it's healing, it's given that feed. So maybe that's what worked, but we still have to find out. If we use our modern science to improve these practices, then we have an alternative that's better than modern science and is very available to the people who need them.
Oral cultures do not have this fundamentalist disease, and that is because there's a constant fluidity, a constant questioning of the word, simply because it flows, it is used, so it is manipulated to suit new experiences. On the contrary, religions like Christianity, Islam, have developed very vicious, both of them have developed very vicious, fundamentalist sects at certain periods of their existence, simply because of this sacrosanctity of the word. Can you imagine an ordinary book becoming such a holy, sacrosanct instrument that you kill for it. You kill for it. So somebody handled it the wrong way, and therefore you kill for it. Somebody did not obey certain injunctions in a book that was created by a human society, and then you kill, you torture, mutilate. That was, you know, sort of pointing out that contrast. You know, saying we should look into the ontology of the written word and see whether it hasn't actually done, brought more grief to the world than the unwritten process of knowledge. But of course, I still prefer books, don't misunderstand me. I like books.
I don't know that I'm a day for a lot. Nima found any deletable for later below. Oh, Adam Adinacon. Only would you leave? Feminate Adamadiacono, Adamadia Tabalo. Andunga Baremui. Cadambu la Sabati. Ebe Baro Unana. Taruku Yata to me. Ebe Anyafo Unana. Seven in Taro. O Abbe Fode, Cafo, 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 Cafo. Femi Iba made Lula.
Caravan has reached Tigray, whose inhabitants have tapped the hidden wealth of inherited oral knowledge to modernize the province. By turning to traditional systems of lending and borrowing, they have breathed new life into an ancient means of survival. The unity that pervaded the villages of old has been revived and renewed to accord with modern needs. The people have learned from experience that alien methods and technology are very mixed blessings.
The credit and saving, it is not new to Tigray or to Ethiopia. What we did is that, based on the strength and the weakness of the traditional credit and saving practices, knowledge, we have developed modern, effective, efficient, low-cost credit and saving throughout Tigray. We have supported many clients with a small amount of money, and they have started small business, opening small shops, and selling also bread and different type of food stuff in the market. But the overall objective of the credit and saving is it will create employment. Unemployment is a major problem in our society.
The caravan brings knowledge in its train as it traverses a variety of natural features, conditions, and epochs. A varied array of languages and cultures have passed on vital knowledge. When cultures wither and die, people's knowledge of nature, plants, and agriculture dies with them. This makes Africa increasingly vulnerable to disastrous famines. The women of Tembien have retained and cherished what others have lost, and are thus able to pass on local knowledge. In this building, they store and sort seeds suited to all the climatic zones and soils in the region. to ward off further natural catastrophes. The local seed banks ensure a supply of viable seeds for farmers, seeds resistant to both drought and disease. Many East African farmers are also intent on reviving knowledge of ancient varieties of seeds, grain and vegetables, which are in danger of dying out.
This is the cowpeas. That is what our old parents were using, and nowadays we want to bring it back to our people, because nowadays we don't, most of us doesn't know, even our children, they don't know these vegetables, but they are very nice to eat, easy to cook, even to plant. You know, during the drought, this cowpeas has been here. We have been using it without problems. That is what is there during the drought, and it is nice.
If you take my experience, the seed for modernization are at the grassroots level, and I'm surprised that this has not been given much attention. Most politicians in Africa, they are not linked with the grassroots level. They try to adhere to imported models. So as a result of it, they try to displace, to marginalize the entire traditional practices, knowledge, skill. That's why disaster comes.
Engaged in a second liberation struggle. We are engaged in a struggle against internal colonialism of selfish leaders, you know, power-corrupted leaders. That is what the phase of struggle in Africa is today. I have a feeling that the ancestors would, first of all, take a whip and flog their descendants, you know, flog them thoroughly, shame them in the open square. I think that's probably what they would, that'd be the first thing, and then sit them down and lecture them. If they look within their own tradition, they will find certain democratic principles embedded even in systems of kinship. It is those traditions of control, of participation, of accountability, which they should develop and bring their society out into the modern world.
Puisque c'est à partir de l'Homo erectus que l'être humain a quitté l'Afrique pour aller peupler les autres continents. Donc nous avons apporté en réalité la technologie et la science qui existaient à l'époque. Elles sont parties de l'Afrique.
Now a new kind of caravan of knowledge is wending its way through West Africa, where a quiet revolution is taking place in the countryside. The farmers behind the NUM movement are adopting a new approach to ancient ecological methods of agriculture. Now they have become Africa's largest and fastest growing smallholders association. These rows of stones show how simply things can be done. Here, yields have increased by 30% without recourse to imported fertilizers and technology.
Ici, vous avez les cordons pierreux. Parce que quand la pluie tombe, le peu d'eau qui tombe est retenu par les cordons pierreux. Et c'est retenu également par le zaï. Ça, c'est une technologie traditionnelle que nous avons améliorée.
Au
niveau des lames, nous faisons deux choses. Premièrement, donner le goût du travail à quelqu'un. Lui demander d'y mettre la bonne volonté, le cœur. Et ensuite, lui apprendre la technique et ça marche. D'ailleurs, nous avons organisé, nous avons inventé une méthode qui s'appelle les 3A. Auteur, acteur, âme. Le paysan, il est auteur de son projet, il est acteur sur le terrain, et ensuite, il y met le cœur, la bonne volonté, et nous avons appelé cela âme, donc 3A, auteur, acteur, âme. C'est ainsi que nous avons contourné les interdits et les coutumes pour pouvoir travailler. Nos ancêtres, du moins nos vieux, ils disent qu'aujourd'hui la démocratie là, qui vient d'Europe, c'est une démocratie qui ressemble au tam-tam. Ça sonne fort, mais à l'intérieur c'est vide. Tandis que la démocratie ancienne, du côté même que nous pratiquons, la démocratie solide. Alors, et donc, il y a la démocratie, il y a l'égalité, il y a la justice, il y a l'équité. C'est une bonne coopérative. Parce qu'ici, c'est déjà pauvre. Donc, il faut conserver. L'environnement, il faut le sauvegarder. Alors, donc, ça fait partie de notre philosophie d'action. Les morts ne sont pas morts.
Ils sont dans le creux de l'arbre. Ils sont sous l'arbre. Ils sont dans l'ombre. Les morts ne sont pas morts. Les morts restent vivants. Parce que nous avons hérité de ces morts-là des valeurs que nous, groupement NAM en particulier, nous voulons sauvegarder par tous les moyens.
The Yoruba believe in the continuity of existence. The ancestor world, the world of the living, and the world of the unborn. And around it all is what we call, what I use expression, the zone of transition. Because it's through that zone of transition that you pass from ancestor to the living, living, unborn, unborn to living, living to ancestor, and round again. And this worldview is, as you see, rejects linearity. You know, believes very much that there's a constant interflux of the force of life.
Quand on se connaît soi-même, on sait mieux connaître les choses. C'est pour cela la société africaine considère que la tradition est un élément qui ne nous fixe pas dans le passé, mais nous donne les instruments qui nous permettent de ne pas trop tirer sur ce que sera l'héritage des générations futures, mais de leur léguer en héritage ce qu'il y a de meilleur, de libérateur, et comme une durée et une densité que le futur doit déployer et diluer pour occuper l'espace et traverser le temps.
This is the problem of the European societies now and the American societies. They are suffering from what I call arrivism. They think they have arrived. They think they don't have to do any other thinking that they have arrived. And this is always a precondition for collapse of civilizations. Once you get that complacency, it's not good.
Jeff ngel mi fe o funden de be hakli mbo site je hakli ni nam ore atu anko Thank you.
محاسنك بمن يدر المالك تمن والله نور عين نور زمن وما شفنا في طول الزمن صور بدر وداخل كمن والله نور عين نور زمن الأنوار يتزاحمن في خدودك أخذوا الأمن ومن فاهك يتقسمن بروق في بروق يتبسمن والله نور علي ونور زمن أجس محاسنك بمن يدر المالك تمن والله نور علي ملاك لابس بدن والله نور علي ونور الزمن انسى لكي